So that was a pretty comprehensive win. You must be pleased the way you played.
Yeah, happy for the way that we play, but also thinking that it's just one more game. We need to keep this. Now we show a little bit what we want to do with this 3-4-3. We need to change a little bit for the next game. But great, satisfied with the work that the players are doing. And just this is not just one more step. But knowing that there are a long way and will come a lot of difficult games in front, that we need to find the solution for to be successful.
Were you getting worried that you couldn't finish it off? It took a long time before you got that first goal and you had so many chances, but...
Yeah, this is important in football is to create this chance. And if you create, sooner or later you will score. The problem is when you don't create, I am thinking, oh, we are having a lot of chance, we are not scoring, but inside of me, I have this confidence that one of these need to go in, and after, when you open, you should think that Brisbane is a good team, and it's not easy to beat them. And I think that we did well.
Bruce, was it nice to get off to a scoring start in the first game of Coopers for the season?
Yeah, it's always good to score goals, but I think most importantly, what I was most satisfied with is how dominant the performance was. I felt that we had a lot of the ball, I felt we had a lot of possession, and you know, we're playing Brisbane Road, who are renowned for being the benchmark of the competition and playing a good style of football and having the majority of possession. And before the game I said this will be a good test for us, a good gauge as to where we're at. It's important we don't get ahead of ourselves, but I think we're tracking well.
Is that close to your best 11, do you think, Jose?
Oof, it's difficult because we have a lot of injuries. In my mind, I have a lot of things for to do, but with this kind of injury, it's difficult. With the players that I have, yes. When the players will recover, I think that we can improve. But we need to wait that these players come and be fit, not just come and be fit. But with the players that we have in this moment, yes, this is the first 11 that we have in this moment.
I think you're playing Sydney FC, if I'm right. Next game away, so it makes it a bit tougher. So I'm not too sure when the actual game's going to be played, but is that okay to be facing it?
And then it's a cup, we can control this, it's a draw, and we play Sydney against Sydney. Then you would want to win the trophy, you need to play against all the teams and be successful. I am a little bit worried in what that is in October. We will start the league. We have a lot of injuries, plus 3 or 4 players that will go with the young soccerers to play the official tournament. At the moment, for example, like today, Iowa, Marco Shane, Wayne Wallen, Izzo, they will be here with us. And if we don't recover players, we don't have a lot of players. And play Sunday or Saturday, midweek, and next Saturday or Sunday, will be hard for us, but we will see which is exactly the day. We will try to do the best that we can and try to be competitive in both competitions, because in the end, I think it's important, but also this cup, we need to bring importance to this cup, and we want to try to do the best that we can.
Mike Mulvey was saying that the atmosphere was a bit weird with the two stands closed off, and it didn't really feel like a cup match to him. Bruce, did you have the same kind of feeling out on the pitch?
No, I thought the fans that came were fantastic. I think the stadium looks fantastic. Obviously, when there's 14, 15,000 people and the stand is full, it's better. But I think it was a pretty good turnout for considering the time and maybe the FA Cup being fresh and new and not as well known as the 10th season of the A-League. But I thought it was a good atmosphere. Obviously, you can get a better atmosphere when the stadium's full, like I said, but no, I didn't feel like I didn't have a cup feel or anything like that. I don't second Morgan's thoughts.
How are you going to balance the cup and the league? Are you going to prioritise one over the other?
No, I need first to know exactly the day. Now in this moment, I don't know. And after that, make a plan, thinking in the play that they have, thinking in which conditions they are, thinking against which player, which team we play in the league. After that, we will decide what we do, if this would go now. I have in my mind that in 1 week I will have three games, or yeah, close to 3 games in 1 week, and maybe I don't have players enough, because if it's close to the starting of October, the players from the youth soccer will go, and the players that I have injured on will be recovered. In the moment we will have a problem, because if we play these 3 games with 14 players, it will be difficult. But now it's good to. I want to sleep this night, tomorrow see, and after start the thing, and prepare the best way that we can. And if so there are players that are youth, young, in the youth, that they will have this young contract, youth contract with us, that they are training with us, and maybe they can play, like Juan or Parla, or Nathan, Bruce Camus, that they are not going to the young soccer. And I like the way that they play, maybe they can play.